everyone, Miss Carrie here from Miss Carrie's Creations. Today I am creating for the creative design team. We are doing a Love Your Stash challenge throughout the month of February. Let's take a look at all of the challenges you will get to see throughout the month. This week we are using paper or pocket cards from our stash, and we would love for you to join us in this challenge. Use the hashtag CDT Love Your Stash when you post your projects so that we can see what you made from some of the items in your collection. All right, let me show you how I use some of the paper and PML cards in my stash. I'm going to be creating a page using this photo of my daughter. I've grabbed a couple of papers from my stash. Some of these are mix-ins, we have Bloom with Grace, and we have some of the new wood grain paper. I thought all of these match the photo really well. I'm going to go ahead and grab my pocket card collection and start thumbing through to try to find cards that are going to complement this photo. Close to my heart has PML cards or Picture My Life cards, which are pocket cards. You can use these as backgrounds, you can use these as complements, you can use them in our pocket memory protectors. I have quite a collection here, so I was pretty excited to be able to use up a few of these in this stash busting challenge. All right, so I've picked out a couple of different pocket cards here that I feel are going to complement the photo and go well with the papers that I've chosen. Some of these are really, really old. Others are recent. You can still find some of those Bloom with Grace ones on my website, but I feel like these go well with my daughter's photo. Some of these pocket cards were chosen because of the designs that were on them or the words that I could use as a title. I'm going to show you how I take these apart to place on my scrapbook page. I also chose a couple of these blue pocket cards. These are from a recent collection, and I'm not quite sure if I want to use them yet, but I do like that they complement the blue in her photo well. So we'll wait and see what happens if I end up using all of these cards or just a few of them. I'm going to start out by using that wood grain paper for my background. I'm going to trim off that little zip strip at the top and turn the paper so that the wood grain is actually going horizontally. I think I like that look better with the vertical photo. The next two pattern papers are mix-ins. Each season we have mix-in papers, and I actually use these quite a bit more than I do our monthly pattern papers. I also collect a lot of these mix-ins, so I'm glad to be using some of them up in our Love Your Stash challenge. I chose to use this black one with some flowers, and I chose one with diamonds. It's a espresso brown color. I felt both of these had kind of a Western feel and matched her photo well. Right now, I am trying to figure out which of those PML cards that I grabbed are going to complement the background papers I chose. I really like the look of this black and white one, so I know that I will use it. These two colors kind of match her shirt, but not quite. And that blue is off a little bit, so I'm not going to be using it. I have another card that matches that black and white lace card. This one has chevron shapes. I'm going to take advantage of those shapes and cut right along that V and use this as a decorative element on my page. I honestly have no idea what collection this comes from. It is an older retired set, so some of you might have it in your stash. Right now, I'm creating a couple of mats for my photo. I like having white trim around my photos, so I've chosen French vanilla as the first mat and sangria as the background piece. This not only matches her shirt, but it really helps the photo stand out on the page. So here's what happened at this stage of the game. I got super frustrated. I think I was overwhelmed by too many PML cards, and I actually went and got my husband and I said, I really need help narrowing this down. And this is what we ended up picking together to complement my daughter's photo. So now I'm going to start layering all of those elements that we picked, and I'm going to start putting this page together. I've got those two background paper strips that are going to go there on the wood grain paper. We picked this watercolor PML card to go behind the photo. And here's that chevron PML that I cut. It's going to go over on the left. Now I need a matching piece over on the right. And I realized when I initially cut it, I cut it where the diamonds weren't going the same direction as the chevron piece there over on the left. So I have to recut this PML card so that all of my diamonds are facing the same direction so that it looks like it's one complete piece. I did like those rounded corners that the PML card had originally. So I've gone and grabbed my corner rounder and I'm going to round the corners of that card. And now I have where it looks like it's a complete piece behind the photo. I went and grabbed my VersaMat so that when I adhere these strips down on the page, they are straight. I'm able to match the 7.5 at the top with the 7.5 at the bottom, and I know that that vertical strip is going straight on this wood grain page. Right now, I'm just adhering all of the background pieces onto that wood grain so that I can start adding all of my die cuts and sticker elements onto this layout. I don't know if you noticed, but I did add stitching onto the diamond paper. I might add some over on the left later, not quite sure. I like to add texture to my scrapbook layouts, and stitching is one of the ways that I can do that. It's just a fine little detail that I enjoy adding occasionally. So we have this sunflower PML card, and I always like to plan ahead just in case I want to use another element on the card later. So I might want to use that stand tall somewhere else, and so I don't want to destroy it. I've made sure I've cut on the opposite side so I know where it ends, and I'm going to be using the find the sun portion on the other side. So by cutting this PML card this way, I now have two statements that say stand tall and, which I can either use on this layout or save for another project later. I know that might have seemed a little time consuming, but most of our PML cards are two-sided, and I hate for any little element to go to waste. Now that the title's been cut out, I can finish adding the rest of the elements onto the page. This is a photo of my daughter on a ranch where she lives. She's going to school about 2 hours away from here. Occasionally, she will post a photo, and I try to get the original from her. When your children are adults and not living at home, it's difficult to get photos, but you still have memories. I remember when she moved down to this ranch, when she moved away, and I want to be able to record that memory. Now I'm to the point where I can start embellishing. Since we are loving our stash, I'm going to use items like this. I have no idea where it came from. I do know it's a close to my heart item, and it matches this layout perfectly. One thing I realized about using both current and past close to my heart products, they all go well together. Whether you're using something you bought yesterday or something you bought 10 years ago, they all seem to complement each other. And there's such a sense of accomplishment using up items I purchased years ago. I had forgotten how much I enjoyed some of these older collections. The pocket card I used behind the photo is from the Bloom with Grace collection, so I have grabbed a Bloom with Grace sticker sheet to grab a few items that I know will match this layout. I have my anti-static pouch over there on the right, and that's helping me to remove the stickiness from the back of the stickers so that I can place them on the layout without having to commit to where they're being placed. I've taken that title that I cut from the sunflower pocket card and I've placed it on top of a heart sticker that is the same color as the pocket card behind the photo. I've also grabbed this skull, which I feel matches the theme of the layout very well. It has some flowers on it, and those flowers match the smaller pocket card. So I decided to add a third batch of flowers up by the title. This little red flower is from an older collection. Off camera, I'm pulling from my album of die cuts. This is how I organize my die cuts, by Roy G. Biv in 8x8 albums. They are temporarily adhered to pages, and it's easy for me to just grab the items I need in the color that matches my elements. So I'm just going to keep grabbing from that album, finding additional elements to match this page. I honestly have no clue what collections any of these came from because they're divided by color, not by collection. So I know that this little red chevron circle matches the little flower circle that I picked, which matches the skull and all of the other sangria elements on here because they were all in the same red section of my album. I'm adding some words to my page. This one is from the Yesterday and Today collection. This is actually a vintage collection we had within the past year, but the words are a deep brown color that match the rest of the layout. This little sticker says loved. It's going to go up there in a corner. I've also grabbed some more word stickers. I think these are from Bloom with Grace. And this one says time to bloom. So it says find the sun, time to bloom over there on the title. I think that's the perfect title for someone who is moving into her first new home. I've grabbed two more sentiments for the pocket card. The So Beautiful comes from that Bloom with Grace collection, and I matched it with the words You Are. Those came from the Yesterday and Today sticker sheet. These two collections go really well together on this layout. Now we're going to speed up the video. I have all of my elements laid out on the page. Since I used that anti-static pouch, none of the stickers are actually stuck down onto the page. I was able to move them around until I got the look that I enjoyed. I'm just grabbing my tape runner, some thin foam tape, some thick foam tape, foam dots, all kinds of different adhesives to give me the different layers that I want on the page. I just signed up for a class to learn how to add layered elements onto a page. When I began recording my memories back in 1995, the market for scrapbooking items was very slim. You did not have all of these three-dimensional elements. You did not layer those elements on the page. Everything was very flat and very structured. My hope for the class is that I become more comfortable layering elements on a page and that I learn a few tips and tricks for putting these elements together. I plan on sharing all that I learn from this class with you as I create more scrapbook pages throughout the year. All right, so this is the point where I step back and I take a look and I see what's missing. I have a little yellow flower here and I have some yellow in her shirt, but I want to visually balance this layout by creating a triangle of yellow elements. So I'm going to add a little yellow sticker up there in the corner. I have also covered the blue dot with a sticker that looks like a little Brad. So I've grabbed these studs and I'm going to add a couple of them to the page. I think these studs kind of give a nice Western feel to the page. I'm going to be placing one up on the tag and then I'm going to place another one under the word love. All right, so I left the layout overnight. I came back the next morning, and like most of us do, we realize it needs a few changes. I felt like the yellow circles were unbalanced, so I added another yellow circle under the words time to bloom. I also wanted to decorate the pocket card that was behind the photo. So I added a couple of triangle studs on this page, which matched the other studs I added earlier. Now, the biggest thing I realized was that I did not have a place to record my memories, the most important part about scrapbooking. So I placed that pocket card inside a flip flap, and now I have two spots, one to record my memories and one to record my daughter's. On this layout, I was able to use quite a few papers and pocket cards in various ways. The black and white floral pocket cards and the watercolor pocket card were used behind the photo. This one was used as a title, and this one was placed inside a flip flap, and it's going to be used for journaling. Using elements from my stash gave me such a sense of accomplishment, and it was very freeing. I hope that you feel the same way. When you join the creative design team in our February Love Your Stash Challenge, don't forget to use that hashtag whenever you post any of your stash busting creations. I want to thank you for joining me today as I created my first Love Your Stash creation. I hope that you enjoyed this layout and that you were able to learn a few new techniques and were inspired to try something new. Tomorrow, Jema will be sharing her Love Your Stash creation with you. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you are notified when I add next week's Love Your Stash creation. If you missed any of the previous Love Your Stash projects, you can click on the collection icon above. I hope you have a wonderful week, and I can't wait to see what you create.